ठीक है, सो नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस सेशन इज अबाउट कुकुम्बर. सो लास्ट टाइम इन द लास्ट वन आई एक्सप्लेन फॉर्म एज वेल एज सम कुकुम्बर स्टफ. सो अब मैं कुकुम्बर वापस आता हूँ. ओके, सो वी हैव दीज फीचर फाइल्स आई एक्सप्लेन. ओके, लेट मी स्टार्ट विद रन टेस्ट. दिस टेस्ट, रन टेस्ट इज रिक्वायर्ड. वाई? दिस विल ट्रिगर योर टेस्ट. ओके, वेन यू इवन वेन यू यूज फॉर्म डॉट एक्सएमएल, राइट, it actually triggers run test only. And one more peculiar thing which you I would like to tell here, that is if you rename this, if you give it any name other than run test, or if you remove that test part from it, even Maven will not run this. Okay, how Surefire works is Surefire checks if you have any file, class file, whose name is ending or starting with TEST, test. Did you guys knew this? Right. So maybe last time I think we discussed about it. If you are not sure about it, I'm telling this again. Run, you need to give it a name as run test. Not run, but TEST is important. Only then Surefire will pick it. Okay. If you are not using Surefire, you are using Maven Failsafe, then your test should be named as IT. IT should be there. Meaning integration test. Okay, IT Maven fail safe. So if I want to run this via run Maven fail test, I will need to give it something like run IT integration test. IT name has to be there, only then it will pick it for execution. But if you are not very fond of creating giving names as IT's run test, aapko apna tumhara naam dena hai, de do. Then in the main Maven fail safe and Surefire, you need to mention actually. Include these files, then it will take it. So, sab possible hai. Agar aap explicitly na dena nahi chahte ho, then just give your name and run test. In that industry standard is this only. Run test and ITs. Okay? IT is being used for, this will be picked by Maven Failsafe. Run test will be picked by Maven Surefire. Integration test. IT means integration test. Again, explanation for that also, but I'll not go there. Otherwise, we'll digress from the whole agenda of today's session. Right? Read what integration tests are, when it gets executed. Wo padho. Maven fail safe. Maven ke post integration verify phase pe trigger hota hai. Surefire trigger hota hai Maven ke test phase pe. Study this. Okay. So I'll come here. Here you need to mention run with as cucumber.class. In Cucumber options, you need to mention feature, glue, tags, plugin, dry run. Features are responsible for where you can mention where your feature files are kept. Glue is responsible where your step definitions are kept. Right now it's empty, but you can mention where exactly you kept it. Why it's empty? Because right now it's no need, because Maven is able to find, locate the step defs, or not Maven, Cucumber is able to find the locate the step defs here. If I actually go and change the package structure, the package structure change karta hun, and main thoda tree structure bana deta hun ki step def ke andar ek aur package hai, then we have one more package and there are step defs are kept, right? In that case, we need to mention the glue here. Similar dot representation karo, start from here. So you can start from here, like step defs dot xyz dot, and that's where your step defs are kept. You can configure that step defs from here. Okay. Right now I'm keeping this empty. What are tags? Tags indicates which specific scenarios or feature files you wish to run. Okay. I can create multiple run tests. Run test 1, run test 2, run test 3, run test 4. And I can mention different tags there. Okay. I can mention different tags and feature files. Sorry, different tags there for each run test. So that this run test only run this feature file having this tags, all those things I can do. I can even mention different combinations of those tags, and or, and or not. All this information I can also do it from there. You know what tags are? Tags are similar to. Okay. Can you compare this with TestNG? Groups. You know, in TestNG we do groups. We create group as smoke, we create group as regression, sanity, right? Same way it works here. This is how we control the flow of execution. And we can control what needs to be executed, what need not be executed. That combinations, controlling of what needs to be executed is done from tags. Okay. Now you have plugin. Plugin is usually used for reporting purposes. So we have pretty means sundar. So agar aapko sundar report chahiye to aapko mention karna padega pretty. Okay. Ugly is by default. If you don't mention it, it will generate ugly report. Okay. Then you mention HTML, that you used to generate an HTML report. So Cucumber has this feature to generate HTML report. It's not very beautiful, but it's still, nonetheless, it's a report which tells you about kya kya hai, kya kya hua, kya run kya, etc., etc. Then you have a JSON generate. Now you can ask why JSON is created. JSON is used by different plugins. Right? JSON mein information hoti hai, kya execute hua, kya execute nahi hua, and all the information about that execution flow. And this JSON, different plugins can use. For example, Jenkins, there's a plugin which uses this JSON file to generate its own report. Right? So last time in Jenkins session, we discussed that, how Jenkins generates report. Then you have another plugin here, which is an extend Cucumber plugin. What it does is, it traces the flow. Traces feature files, scenarios, steps, definitions, logs, it traces everything while execution, and it generates its own HTML report, which is very, very beautiful. Okay, even more beautiful than these HTML reports. Okay, that's how extend report is implemented. And trust me, and understand this, this is different way how we are generating extend report here. There are two representations or two implementations of extend report. One was old, one was new. The old representation, you might not be doing this. In old representation, you are actually creating the object of extend report. So extend HTML, you know, all these objects you create. At runtime, you use those objects to generate, write the logs. But this is the new implementation of, it's called as extend Cucumber adapter. Quite few people are aware of it. If you go to interviewer, in all likelihood, he will not be aware of it. He will say, okay, let's not we do it. He would expect more about object wala approach. Aap wo nahi bataoge, he will say that was the old approach. We are using in our framework the new approach. This was launched in 2018. So it's already been 1.5 years when it was launched. You say we use this. The benefit of using this is you don't have to mention the extent object anywhere in your code, and it will automatically will pick your steps for you. Okay? Getting it? So don't. Someone in the group, I think someone was asking, I think Amit was asking this, ki hame purana bhi seekhna hai, no. Hame sab nahi seekhna hai. We are not doing PhD here. Okay? It's not a PhD course, it's not even a master's course. This is a get job fast job course. Okay? Whatever it takes to get a faster, get a job faster, that is what we are doing. Okay? Then dry run is either true or false. If it's not mentioned, then it will by default it will be false. Dry run means you're running the code dry. That means you're not actually running it, you're just simulating it. When it's true, it will go through all the steps, but not actually execute it. It will just go through it. Purpose for this is, if you're writing step and you want to write its signature methods, you can use this. I'll tell you how it's used. Right now it's marked as true. That means the code will not execute, but it will actually dry run it. It will go through all the scenarios and will check whether its step definition is present. If it is not present, it will generate it for you. Okay. Now we have a feature files. This is a feature file. This is a feature file. Background is used something like before scenario. Not before scenario. Something, if you talk about testng, you have before method, right? Annotation. But before any scenario, this will be executed. So if I want to run this, first this will be executed, background. And it is common for all the feature file under the purview of that run test, okay? So background, if written one feature file, in the next feature file also, background will be executed first, right? The scope of that is defined from run test. अगर आप फीचर हमें सारे फीचर फाइल लिखे हुए हैं सो दैट मींस इट विल ट्राई टू फाइंड बैकग्राउंड इन ऑल द फीचर फाइल्स. अगर आपने यहाँ पे केवल एक ही फीचर फाइल लिखी हुई दैट मींस ओनली एंड टू एंड दैट मींस दिस वन दिस फीचर फाइल यू हैव मेंशन देन ये फीचर बैकग्राउंड विल नॉट बी कंसीडर्ड फॉर एग्जीक्यूशन. गेटिंग इट? सो दैट्स हाउ वी डिफाइन द स्कोप ऑफ फीचर फाइल कि क्या रन होने हो वो सब कुछ रन टेस्ट से कॉन्फिगर होता है. राइट? अगर ऐसा बाउंसर जा रहा है तो कोई बात नहीं, यू हैव टू ट्राई. ठीक है? But run test is used for configuration of what will be executed and where it will find feature file, where it will find step depths, what will be executed is governed by tags, plugins for report generation. Abhi aage se what is the Kumar option? Simple hai. Okay. See, when I started learning all this, I was exactly at the same spot where you are. It's not very intuitive. बहुत डिफिकल्टी होती है शुरू में समझने में, बहुत कन्फ्यूजन होते हैं और वो कन्फ्यूजन धीरे धीरे जाते हैं. सो डोंट एक्सपेक्ट, डोंट बी टू हार्श ऑन योरसेल्फ कि नहीं आ रहा है मुझे तो आई एम स्टूपिड और समथिंग. डोंट कंक्लूड दैट वे नहीं आ रहा है बिकॉज इट एक्चुअली टेक्स टाइम. टाइम हील करता है सब, ऐसा ना, सारे जख्म समय के साथ ठीक होते हैं. तो ये जो जख्म है समय के साथ ठीक होगा. यू हैव टू स्पेंड मोर टाइम ऑन इट. दैट्स इट. Right? Okay. I'm not genius. I'm average person. I took my own sweet time to learn it. You also will take the same sweet time. Okay. But give yourself time. But that doesn't mean कि आप कहोगे कि time लगना है तो फिर time के साथ ही सीखेंगे. है ना? तो पढ़ कर ही नहीं रहे. ऐसा भी नहीं चलेगा. Okay. You have to spend time with it. Right? दोस्ती भी ऐसी होती है ना. When you spend more time with a person, then only your friendship grow. So you want this to help you, want to have a build a relationship with Cucumber, you have to spend more time with him. It works that way. Okay? शादी कर लो. इससे शादी कर लो. कुंभ पर शादी कर लो. लोग करते थे ना पहले, पत्थर शादी कर ली, पेड़ शादी कर ली, आज भी करते हैं. शादी कर लो. You marry it. Then you will fight with it. It will exception will come. हाँ, exceptions will come. That is like you are fighting with it. And then you find your own harmony with that relationship. आते हैं शादी में तो प्रॉब्लम आती है. And it is difficult, right? But you need to learn to build a harmony with that relationship, right? So I have harmony with this cucumber framework because I spent time with it, I've struggled with it. मैंने समझा उसको, उसकी feelings को समझी. ठीक है? उसने मुझे बताया कि नहीं ऐसा नहीं, ये गलत है, सही है. तो I've learned it. Mutual understand. So it understood my needs. I understood her needs, not his. In your case, it could be him, but my name is her. Okay, got it. So jokes apart, getting it. You spend need to spend more time. It in a nutshell. So this is background. This is scenario. That's how it will work. If you want to click on it. It will show you the step definitions for it. I am using dependency injection concept here. I have a class called as context class. This is a context class here. In the DI section, I have created a context class. I have specific information here that I am passing to all the step depths. I really don't want to go into detail of explaining what is dependency injection again. Go and watch previous videos. You will see dependency injection concept there. Pretty well explained. Still have doubts? Ask. Okay. So, why I'm using this inside here? Why I'm using this is to pass the information across different step depths. So, I have two step definitions here. I want to make use of access the same object. I am passing this inside the constructor of it. Okay. Okay.
For the next procedure.
Okay.
To select the object and add the card. So it is not. Will it catch?
It will catch. So what you have to do? Let's say I am creating another step depth, and I am giving. Let me create it. So I am creating step depths by underscore. Let's say checkout. Okay. So I'll click on finish. So first thing I would like to do is create a constructor for it. Okay, so I'll create a constructor. Click. in this constructor I would like to parameterize. So I'll write scntxt context, and I will create a local variable which is private scntxt. I'll give it a name as context. And I will write this dot context is equal to cntxt. Right? This is the first thing I will do. Then I can do many things, whatever I wish to do. So I need to access any page object. I need to access any driver. I would need to access any common variable. I will only use context. Okay. Some error is coming.
Yes. Error is not good. I was firstly confused that. Taking or not.
Okay. But it will take. It will take. Yeah. 100%. I'm telling you.
I'm not clear that it is taking.
What
is the fault?
What is the?
What is the fault?
There's an error coming here.
Errors no exception.
But work nahi ho raha hai.
Haan.
Nahi raha. Theek hai. Commit your code. I'll cannot see. I always overcommit. Main bol deta hu aisa karke, lekin main nahi dekh pata hu. But if you commit it. I will get some time. If I'm getting any time, I will have some option to go and look at it. If you don't put it, then I won't see it. You need to keep on pushing. If you put it and ping link, ping karo, dekho maine aisa kiya. Ho sakta hai koi fault ho jo mujhe evident ho, mujhe ekdam dikh jaye. Okay? But this is the thing which you need to do. As simple as that. Okay? Fair enough. So, next thing I would like to tell is, yahan tak clear ho gaya? Next thing is before and after hook. Here I am again injecting something. This is called as Cucumber Native Injection. This is the interface. I am at runtime. I am injecting this. Okay? And I am putting this inside scenario object, which is again part of context object.
In that step definition, should I maintain the flow? So I have continued from like we are having feature type. So we are putting loads of particular methods in that step. So you haven't maintained that flow. You have written setup.
Okay.
And in the second step that you have written search product.
Okay.
So I haven't maintained that flow. I've just created another step and written a select product and all.
Right. Doesn't matter so, flow. Doesn't matter. So, so, actual flow is happening from here. It's good to do that. Logically, it will not fail. But it's good to maintain proper flow. That you need to do. But the order in which you keep it doesn't matter. That's a method, right?
So I don't have to call that search method and all in that particular step.
No, no, I don't. I'm not getting exactly. Maybe you can show me what you mean, but point is things will be managed from here, right? In your case, you can even maintain a single step depth. Everything, koi cucumber or sab eco container or sab koi zaroorat hi nahi padega. No dependency injection needed. If you everything doing it in the same file, but it's not. That's not how realistically it happens. You need to divide it, segregate it, and pass information from here to there. That file. Okay. I don't exactly know what you mean by maintaining the flow. Maybe you can show me. Okay. Actually, flow execution flow is managed from this file. Step depths kahan rakhi hain, wo aap kahin bhi rakh sakte ho. But things are really flown or proper execution flow will happen from this file. Theek hai? Now, last thing which I want to so see, abhi tak hum walkthrough hi kar rahe hain basically, revise hi kar rahe hain. Ab main actual agenda pe to aaya hi nahi. I'll do this quickly. Last thing which I want to do is this before. And after hook, which is not there right now. Before hook, main runtime pe I'm injecting this. Before and after executes, before and after each scenario. Uska bhai hai background, which do the same thing. Background also executes before scenario. Okay? And background ke pehle before hook execute ho jata. So pehle before hook execute hoga, fir background execute hoga, fir scenario execute hoga. If I'm not wrong, that's how the sequence is. Okay? Getting it? Okay. Now I'll go back. I'll go here. I'll create it as different step dev file, not step dev, sorry. End-to-end journey, new feature file. I've written a new scenario here. So you know one way of parameterization of this feature file. That is, you pass something here, you capture it there. But in this case, the problem is it only accepts one value. Either it's integer or it's a string, it only accepts one value, right? Single variable. But what if you want to send some multiple variables, right? If you want to do that, you make use of a data table concept. There is a, in Kokoma, there is a concept called as data table. What it does is, it takes bulk in a form of a collection. Okay, so what I'll do is, let me show you. So I'll remove this from here. So the scenario here I would like to talk about, what if you want to add multiple products? You're doing a scenario where you need to add multiple products. And those products I have mentioned here. So I mentioned the code for those products. From where I am taking it? From here. So I have taken this code and I have taken this code. So I want to add to cart. I want to add this add to cart multiple times. In the same test case, right? So what will I do? I'll do something like this. Okay? This is not examples. You know what examples in Cucumber are? This is different than examples. If I show you what examples are, okay, tell me what are examples. Old people, at least they can tell. What is examples in Cucumber? Exactly. Right? When you're using scenario outline, then you use examples. That is different than what I'm telling you now. So don't get confused. Okay? Maybe I'll tell you that as well. Let's say this is what it is. Okay. All right. So now if I go to run test, if I'm marking it as dry run, okay. And if I go and go here and I kind of end to end is there, right? And if I go to run test, end to end is there, everything is true, and I run this, I run JUnit. Right now dry run is true, it will not execute it, so there will not be any error. But if I already told you in the previous video, previous session, that you need to have set that Cucumber options, okay, because I have written something gibberish here. So if you see, it has ran, it only ran one test case, because in the tags I have written this. That's why it only ran one. And in the this section, console section, it is telling me you can implement missing steps. So now it is telling you something is missing. But if you also notice, let me copy this. I'll go here and in the step def, let's say I'm writing, creating a new step def, for example, or rather let me modify this only. I'm giving for name it as E2E. Okay. It should not be created this way. Step def should be like modular in nature. Like checkout, search, etc. For time's sake, I am creating this for a better explanation. I change this. Here I am pasting this. So if you notice, there is a concept called as little thing. So now what will happen? This specific item, it will take it from outside. What kind of data? This data, it will take it and will store that data into a data table. So all the data is taken now and we'll store it there, data table, right? If you do a data table dot, you will get lot of stuff. That means now data table is Cucumber concept. You want to convert that data into a specific Java collection. So it's saying you want to convert that into a list. You want to convert that into a map, right? List of maps. You see this list of maps. Right? When do you need that? So if you're sending data something like this, let's say price, or let's say quantity. Okay, this case it will be list of maps. Now that I will really like to explain on board. As I said, it was our next agenda, creation of list of maps. Kaise kaam karta hai ye. Okay, but so far so good. Okay. The idea here is simple, which is it will take all that information into data table object, and that data table object you can convert to different Java forms. So list form, hash map, list of hash map, all those information. So there are, if you, it's mentioning, you can convert this to list of elements, list of elements, list of map of elements, map, simple map, map of list. All the possible combinations are there, right? One way is you directly do this data table dot as list or something, or instead of doing this, you can also do something. कि आप ये ना यूज करते हुए डोंट यूज दिस एंड डायरेक्टली मेंशन हियर लिस्ट ऑफ स्ट्रिंग्स. ओके, सो आपको रेडेबल डॉट कन्वर्जन नहीं करना पड़ेगा, वो ऑटोमेटिकली लिस्ट ही मिल जाएगी आपको वहां से, वो बाय डिफॉल्ट कन्वर्ट कर लेगा. इफ यू सी हियर राइट कोड हियर दैट टर्न्स द फ्रेज अबाउट दैट इनटू करेक्ट एक्शंस फॉर ऑटोमेटिक ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन, यू कैन डायरेक्टली मेंशन दिस हियर, चेंज रेडेबल टू वन ऑफ दीस वैल्यूज. कितना समझदार है वो बता रहे हैं, आप सुन नहीं रहे हो. ओके, इट इज टेलिंग यू कि यू कैन आइदर यूज डेटा टेबल एंड देन कन्वर्ट इट, और यू कैन ऑटोमेटिकली ट्रांसफॉर्म इट टू योर डिजायर्ड डेटा फॉर्म, डेटा कलेक्शन. ओके, सो राइट नाउ, नाउ यू गाइस टेल मी, इफ आई एम यूजिंग दिस, व्हाट इट्स गोइंग टू बी, कैन दिस बी स्टोर्ड इन अ लिस्ट ऑफ स्ट्रिंग्स? इट विल नॉट बी. बताओ, लिस्ट ऑफ. ओके, आई एम पॉजिंग, राइट, आई एम पॉजिंग दिस एंड मे बी आई एक्सप्लेन ऑन बोर्ड. ओके, पॉज. ओके, सो आई क्विकली एक्सप्लेन दिस हियर अगेन, वॉट एवर एक्सप्लेन ऑन द बोर्ड. ओके, सो यू हैव दिस कोड क्वांटिटी, आई वॉन्ट दिस टू बी स्टोर्ड इन अ डेटा स्ट्रक्चर. वॉट आई डू इज आई गो हियर एंड आई वॉन्ट टू स्टोर दिस एज अ लिस्ट ऑफ हैश मैप्स. यू सी हियर लिस्ट ऑफ हैश मैप. So I'll write here list of map string, string comma string. I'll give it here as a list. What happened? List of, sorry. List hash map. Okay, and as I said, this data which you have here, if I write, this will be stored in the first element of the list as a hash map. So if I want to access this, let me copy here, maybe for the, okay, if I want to write this, how will I write it? I want to fetch line number 6, for example, right? So what I'll do, I will write list 1 dot get 0 dot get code. This will give me this value. Okay, now you tell me, if I want to access this, this, what will I write? This is the first row, this is second row. I want to know second row quantity value. What I'll write? I'll write list 1 dot get 1, right? Because it starts from 0. So 1 dot get quantity. So I'll write here quantity. Fair enough? That is how basically I can make use of this data and run it. Now, why I'm doing this? I want to create a quote. So inside this, I search and add products. My logic was, okay, I will first search this, then I will add that into my basket. Then I will add this into a basket with specific quantity. So that means I wanted this. That, okay, find this one. Increase the quantity which I mentioned here, 45. So not 45. So let's say 4. And then click on add to cart. This is the scenario. So in a single test case, I'm trying to add single flow. I'm trying to add multiple products with different quantities. This is not iteration. Okay. So if I put this into contrast to scenario outline. So this scenario is different than SCENARIO outline. Search and add multiple products when I search and add products. In basket examples, these two are different things. In this case, this test case will run only once and it will add all these products in a same flow. In this test case, it will run twice. In first flow, it will add this product, it will add this product with this quantity. Then the browser will close and then again browser will open and then it will search for this product. Both are different test cases. This is something similar to data provider in your test engine. This is different, passing data. That's it. This is a simple single test case. This is different. This is different. So don't get confused. This is a data table representation where you want to send multiple data to your feature file in the same test case. In this test case, you are writing this, but for every execution, only single row will be passed. So in this case, you have to write like this. Code. Maybe something like this. With code as on. Code and quantity something like this. So at runtime, what will happen? This will be given here, this will be sent here. This is scenario outline, this is scenario. Both are different. Okay, got it? Whatever video you have taken, give me, I will edit it. And I'll add that with this video, okay? So that you also understand ki exactly kya, what I explained in the board. Okay, get it? Now, Yeah, okay, this is here.
Directly
nahi hoga, you have to write the code. So you need to write an XPath for it. And I have explained that XPath also, XPath access use karke kiya tha maine, if you remember. Purane framework mein you will see that. Right? So I am searching this, ki ye kahan dalna hai. On the same basis, I will have to click on add to cart. So I will have to do what? I will have this code. Then based on this, I need to find where is my text box. Based on this, I need to find where is the add to cart. I wanted to tell this in this class, but we are short of time. You guys try it out. Okay? So this week assignment for you will be complete these test cases, two test cases. Okay, I'll try to write my own code. Let's see how much time I'll get. I'll write it. And but you also write your own implementation of it. Fair enough? Okay.
So, yeah. Suppose you have a data in the form of keys and values.
Uh-huh.
And like, they are in the table, right? So that table is dynamically changing the values. So in that case, how can you
paste
the particular key value?
I don't get the question. You have to explain better. Tell me.
Table has three keys, one is a format, and both of these are old and